Thank you very much, Ajoy, for giving me an opportunity to be here in this wonderful course. And all masters, not only on the dais, but off the dais also, I see so many masters there. But you know, there are certain times that we need to think about the basics also. Can I just have a quick raise of hands of people who are not using, who are using CTR and devices for subluxated, who are using? Fine, that's absolutely, oh. Arup Bhaumik is not using, so please remember. Okay, fine, Arup. Thank you. So we will dwell upon a few situations where we are going to talk about basics, and then of course the advanced techniques have already been shown. I'll also be showing you a few of them. So etiology, we know all these congenital etiologies and acquired etiologies, all these conditions in which we may have the subluxated lenses, and these cataracts deserve special attention and special aspects to deal with them so that we get a good outcome. And the systemic disorders are there. Why I highlight this slide is because we need to care not only for the eyes, but we need to refer them to the respective systemic pathologies, and so that they get a full treatment. Pre-operative evaluation, what Ajay just mentioned, the lens position is very important, phacodonesis during your slit lamp examination or the amount of cataract, and the zonule loss has to be ascertained as much as possible so that you can plan the surgery before you actually go into it. And you must spend time and see whether there is vitreous in the anterior chamber, because if it is there, that has to be dealt hand in hand with your phacoemulsification whenever you're going in. And if there's an inferior subluxation, then there could be a very large amount of subluxation and you might not be able to assess it because the effect of gravity is also there. So let's start with all these few videos that we have. And this one is, when do you put a CTR is the question. The dictum is CTR placed as later as you can, but as early as it deserves. So if you have to put a CTR right in the beginning, then put it right in the beginning. The other aspects can be dealt with, especially the cortex being trapped between the CTR and the capsule. But the CTR is a great device, and you should put in as quickly as possible. The other aspect is the rexis is one of the most important aspects of doing the cataract surgery in the subluxated lens. You can see that we have placed the CTR in the bag and it has gone in very smoothly. And I'm going to show you a few instances when it does not go very smoothly at all. So we'll change the video and go on to another video in which what you are going to see is CTR at times can really give trouble, though it seems so easy, and especially when the masters do it, it seems so easy, so it can give trouble. But before that, let me dwell a little more upon the capsular excess that is being done. Again, your triumph depends upon if you have done a good capsular excess, and you must have at least a 4 millimeter clear of the subluxated area. Center the capsular excess on the lens, on the subluxated lens, and definitely not on the pupil, so that you have a very good rim of anterior capsule when you're putting in your lenses, your devices and everything. Now look at this. So I'm placing the CTR, and what can you see? So once I'm trying to place the CTR, and what has happened, the CTR has gone in through the hook and it has traveled right into the device through which I'm placing it. So the Sinsky hook has not worked, and then it has slipped, and now it has slipped into the angle of the anterior chamber. Now I make a second attempt and try to put it in, and this time it is another hook from the other end, and I'm trying to wiggle it in. And as you can see, these happen with when there are large subluxated areas, because these large subluxations, you do not have the support of the zonules and the bag to place in all these devices, and you're trying to wiggle it in. So again, so it has gone in, and this time it has gone in quite well. you have to be 100% sure, and especially in a very well-dilated pupil, that the CTR has actually gone into the bag and one end is not slipped out into the angle. So the other parts are quite nothing very specific. Let's go on to the next video. And here in this video, what we have is there is vitreous in the anterior chamber, which we had noted, and this amount of vitreous needs to be tackled as and when required. So we make a capsular excess, and the making of the capsular excess, let me again dwell on this. If you can make a good capsular excess with your cystotome, well and good. But whenever you are having trouble with the cystotome, please go ahead and take a micro forceps. A micro forceps comes in from different manufacturers. There are micro forceps which go in through a 1.2 millimeter side port. They are the best, and if you're trying to deal with a subluxated lens, you must have micro forceps and micro scissors in your armamentarium. Without them, please do not go ahead. And the micro forceps gives you a lot of benefit when you are doing it. So here what you can see is, you know, I was trying to do the phacoemulsification and I saw that there was a subluxation. So the area of subluxation needs to be supported. Let us not go in without supporting, because let us remember that the zonules are all in place, and if the zonules are not supported well, then what will happen in the subluxated area, the subluxation will increase. So let us support it with these hooks and devices so that we can get a good and clear way. Let's I think time is short, so I'll just show you. Love showed excellent videos on subluxated lenses, the Marfan syndrome. I'll just show you my disaster in the first case. Here Love did not show a disaster. I have to show you a disaster, because these things are happenings that do happen, and I was trying to do everything right, and you can see that I was trying to do through the micro forceps also, and I'm not able to get a good rexis. And then I tried to put in the CTR, could not put in the CTR, and in the end had to take it out, abort this procedure, and go in for an SFIOL in this procedure. The second eye of this patient, where again the subluxation was quite large, we go in, and what we do is to fill in viscoelastic, high molecular viscoelastic, in the area of subluxation. Thereby, when I'm putting the trypan blue, the trypan blue does not seep into the vitreous cavity, which is very important. Otherwise, you're working in a very dark night situation. Here again, making that first nick can be tough. So you need to have either a cystotome, and in some cases you might have to work with an MVR from the opposite pole. Like this is the subluxated area here, so if nothing works, then you might have to work with an MVR coming in from this, so that at least you are able to make a nick. At times the nick is very important, difficult to make, but it can be done. Can I take one or two more minutes? Okay, so then this one, of course, is a little bit of a triumph of a case. Of course, you have to support the rexis with the ball tip dialer, and once you support it, then you are able to get through with the capsular rexis. And it has to be a gentle procedure. Please take time. Please refill with viscoelastic, and you can actually get a good capsular rexis. Once a good capsular rexis is done in such a difficult Marfan's, most of the work is actually done. So in this case, we are putting in the iris hooks. The iris hooks also supported very well. Again, placing the CTR inside the bag is very important. Love also showed the importance of placing it. And if it has gone out, see how well he could tackle it. And please also remember that the zonules, whatever they are, do help. So nothing is lost, and you need to try. It's only when you have really damaged, or the damage has taken place, that you go ahead and abort the procedure. But the thing is, try till the last. So we again, placing an intraocular lens in such conditions is also important. Here I'm placing the intraocular lens through the nasal side. Why through the nasal side is because the subluxation is on the temporal side. So if I try from the temporal side, then I'm then negotiating the capsule is difficult. So these are things, and you have to do a good suturing, and in case you need to do a good suturing, then you go ahead and see the centration which was shown. Last case I will quickly show, and this is a video that is quite an old video. I'll just show you. This is a spherophakia in which we did lens implantation, and the importance of doing the spherophakia. Again, do attempt spherophakic eyes. Do attempt. In this one, it was a specially difficult condition because the anterior capsule was adhered to the posterior cornea, and that adherence was separated. And what we were expecting is a total white cornea and everything, but really not. So the cornea was well maintained. What was difficult is because of the fibrosis of the anterior capsule. Capsulotomy was difficult, but again we could get a puncture and we could do off the capsulotomy. Again, doing off the capsulotomy, you can see the ball dialer helping me to do the capsulotomy, and you can see the excursion of the forceps going all around. So once that is done, so now what happened, my disaster again here, is I placed in the lens and everything went on well, and but I did not put in the segments. And then after 4 months, this is what I had, a disaster. The lens capsular bag was half in the AC. So what could I do? So this patient was taken up, and what we did is we separated the synechia, and then what we did is we sutured the capsule with the haptic of the lens. It was a single piece lens, and we sutured it off. You can see that we are taking off the synechia, and Ajay, just 30 seconds, this is my last video, and we are able to suture the two ends and of this fibrotic bag along with the along with the haptic in both the ends. And after this is done, it usually stays well in place, and the other eye of the same patient we could do very well. I'm not showing that. And the last photograph is what we had post-operatively. This eye, again, well-centered, but of course not the best of the surgical aspect, but the left eye, which we did put in the two CTR in place, was doing so well and looks so pristine. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.